Thank God for another day. Thank God for another day to worship and to adore his name. Thank God for another day where we can come together and realize how consistent we need to be if we are to continue safely on this journey. Bless the name of the Lord. Welcome to another morning's devotion. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. The text this morning is from John 20, 24 to 29, and it reads, and I'm reading from the New Living Translation. One of the 12 disciples, Thomas, nicknamed the twin, was not with the others when Jesus came. They told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he replied, "I won't believe it unless I see the nail wounds in his hands. Put my fingers into them and place my hand into the wound of his side." 8 days later, the disciples were together again, and this time Thomas was with them. "Peace be unto you," he said. The door was locked, the doors were locked. But suddenly, as before, Jesus was standing among them. "Peace be unto you," he said. Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and look at my hands. Put your hand into the wound in my side. Don't be faithless any longer. Believe." "My Lord and my God," Thomas exclaimed. Then Jesus told him, "You believe because you have seen me. Blessed are those who believe without seeing me." This morning I want to use as a thought, faith in the face of doubt. Today I am sharing a great truth of our faith. Blessed are those who have not seen yet believe. These words spoken by Jesus to his disciple Thomas after his resurrection hold a powerful message for all of us. It does hold a powerful message. And one, because we are not from Jesus' time. Therefore, we have not seen Jesus with our natural eyes. Thomas, one of Jesus' disciples, expressed doubt about Jesus' resurrection, saying he would not believe unless he could touch the wounds of Jesus' body for himself. We live in a world where evidence and proof are highly valued. We are taught to believe only what we can see and touch. The world we live in is not at all different from Thomas's experience. Many Christians struggle with doubts and questions about their faith, especially in the face of adversity, suffering, or difficult circumstances. They may wonder if God is really there, if their prayers are being heard, or if they are truly saved. In the event of doubting Thomas, Jesus appears to him and invites him to touch his wounds, which convinces Thomas of his resurrection And Thomas exclaimed, "My Lord and my God." Jesus responded by saying, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen but believe." This event teaches that it is natural to have doubts and questions about our faith, and it is okay to seek answers and reassurance. However, it also reminds us that faith is not based solely on tangible evidence or personal experience, but on trust in God and His Word. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. In our world where we see materialism personalized, prioritized, science and empirical evidence, it can be difficult to maintain a strong faith in God. But blessed are those who have not seen and believe, family. To be blessed means to be favored, fortunate, regarded divine. When we believe in God's promise, even without seeing, we are blessed because we receive the gift of faith. Faith is a powerful force that can bring us joy, peace, and hope, even in the midst of difficult circumstances. Believe. Belief is not just a mental assent to an idea or concept. Belief is a powerful force that can transform our lives. Our belief in God blesses us. We are filled with hope, joy, peace. We are able to overcome challenges and difficulties, knowing God is with us. Believing in God requires trust, surrender, and obedience. It means trusting in God's promises, surrendering our own desires and plans to His will, and obeying His teachings. In doing so, we are able to experience the fullness of God's blessings in our lives. Oh, hallelujah. Let us strive to deepen our faith and trust in God. Let us be consistent. We are talking about consistency this morning. Let us be consistent in deepening our faith in God. Our faith and our trust in God. That is important. Family, the enemy is always after our faith in God and will at all times try to plant seeds of doubt to rob us of our blessings. And you see that there is blessings attached to our belief in God, to our belief in that Jesus rose again from the grave, and because of that we have life, because of that we have hope, because of that we can believe and we are blessed. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. But today, recognizing that Jesus Himself said it, "Blessed are you who believe and you have not seen me." You are already blessed. We are already blessed. Oh, hallelujah. So we talk about faith. What does it mean to believe in something we cannot see? It means we have faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Paul, who wrote the Hebrews, tells us faith is the substance of things we cannot prove or demonstrate, but that we know in our hearts to be true. We know in our heart to be true. Amen. Faith is not blind belief. However, it is not simply a matter of believing something without any evidence or reason to support it. Rather, faith is based on the evidence that God has given us through His Word, through the testimony of others who have experienced His grace and mercy, and through the witness of the Holy Spirit in our hearts. When we have faith, we are able to see beyond the physical world and enter into the spiritual realm. Oh, hallelujah. We are able to see that there is a God who creates us, or who created us and loves us, and who wants to live in us consistently. Hallelujah. We are able to see a purpose in our lives, and that we are a part of a bigger picture. Hallelujah. However, as Christians, we are called to something greater. Glory to God. We are called to have faith in God, even when we cannot see Him. This kind of faith is not easy. I must admit, it requires us to trust in something that we cannot fully understand or comprehend. Many things blow our mind. It requires us to let go of our doubts and fears and place our trust in God's love and amazing grace. Thank you, Jesus. Family, when we do this, we are blessed beyond measure. Our faith becomes a source of strength and hope, guiding us through the challenges and difficulties of life. It fills us with a sense of purpose and meaning, reminding us that we are a part of something greater than ourselves. We see some examples of this kind of faith throughout the Bible. Abraham, who trusted in God's promise to make him the father of many nations, even though he and his wife were well past childbearing age. Moses, who trusted in God's plan to deliver the Israelites out of slavery, even though the journey should be long. The journey would be long and difficult. Mary, who trusted God's plan to bring about salvation through her son, even though it meant enduring sorrow and pain. If you are struggling with doubts about your faith, seek the truth. And I'm sure you get it when you come on here at JGRFM in the morning. Bless the name of the Lord. Seek the truth. Instead of ignoring your doubts or suppressing them, explore them. Study the Word of God. Find the truths. They are there. Hallelujah. Pray. Ask God to reveal Himself to you in ways that will strengthen your faith. Be open to the possibilities that He may answer in unexpected ways. Hallelujah. Attend a Bible-based church. Worship with other believers. Strengthen your faith. Let it go down deep. Hallelujah. Be consistent in going after God hard. Glory to God. Seek wise counsel from trusted Christian leaders. And seek at all times, as I said before, to deepen. I cannot overemphasize that. To deepen your relationship with Christ Jesus. Glory to God. So family, let us embrace this truth of our faith. Embrace this truth of our faith. Blessed are those who have not seen yet believe. Glory to God. Let us be people of faith, trusting in God's love and grace to guide us through the challenges of life. May our faith be a light in the darkness, a source of hope in the midst of despair, and a testimony to the power of God's love. Bless the Lord. I believe with all my heart. I believe with all my heart that God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. Hallelujah. And therefore, I have every confidence that I am blessed. Are you? Let us pray. Glory to God. Gracious God, we come before you today to lift you up in prayer, to lift up someone in prayer. All those who have struggled or are struggling with doubts, just like Thomas did, we ask that you would help them to find peace in the midst of their uncertainties and to trust you in your love and grace. We pray that you would provide them with the evidence and reassurance they need to believe in you and in your promises. Help, O God, as many seek the truth of your word and the realities of your presence in their lives. God, I pray that you will come through for them. You did for Thomas. Lord, we know that doubt can be a difficult and painful experience. So we pray that you would give them the strength and courage to persevere through it, to be consistent, God, in finding you. Help them to hold on to their faith, so when they are feeling unsure or overwhelmed, Lord, you will satisfy, God, that void. Mighty God, we ask that you would surround them with love and supporting people who can offer them guidance and encouragement along the way. Bless here the work of Evangelist Angela and the family, the destiny workers, the pastors, and all those who come on morning after morning. Mighty God, help, Lord, that this be continued through this medium to reach the doubters, to reach the unreached, the sick, the dying, those who are in need of hope. We ask these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. God bless you, JGRFM family. Let us go out today and be consistent in our faith. Let us be consistent in the things we do so that God will be glorified. God bless you.